This video is going to demonstrate the resolve property when you're configuring your routes in AngularJS. Now this is kind of an advanced example, so I've included the source and the demo in the description of the video, so make sure to check those out. I'm definitely going to focus on the why to use this rather than the how, because it's more important to understand the difference between not using it and using it. Than to go kind of step by step through the code and explain every little piece of how to set it up. Hopefully the demo will serve that purpose, and I'm going to focus again on showing you this before bad example and then an after good example. So let's start with the before example. So if you look over here, if I click on Enterprise D, you can see that automatically jumps to the Enterprise D tab, the image renders immediately, and then rank and name appear, and then the data loads, then you finally see the data set. So the behavior is automatically jump to the view, render everything you can, and then once the data comes, render the rest of it. So if you've never seen the resolve property before, that's probably what your app is doing right now. If we compare this to the good after example, we'll go back to the home and refresh here. When I click on Enterprise D, now you'll see it'll do a kind of an application-wide loading, and then it'll take its time for the data to be prepared. And then once the data is ready to be displayed, then it'll switch over and render the view appropriately. You'll see again, when I click on Voyager, it'll be loading. Then once everything's ready, it'll render out the entire page. You won't have any holes in your view or anything. Everything will just look nice. Another benefit of this is that if you navigate to a page that doesn't exist, say for example Warbird, it'll try and load that page, but it does not navigate away from your current view. So that view stays put. It tries to resolve that Warbird. It sees it doesn't get a data set, so it doesn't change the view. It sticks with what it already has. So this is a much better example, in my opinion. It behaves a lot more like Gmail. That's why I compared it to Gmail in the title of this. Because in Gmail, if you click on, you know, start or any of your labels, you'll see that it doesn't automatically switch over and show you an empty inbox. It'll wait a second. Once the data is ready, then it'll show that little loading bar at the top, and then it'll display it once the data is ready. So this to me is a much better user experience. So let's kind of dive into what this is all about to show how you use it without kind of going line by line. I just want to show how it all kind of hooks up and works together. So the first thing you'll notice is this route that I've configured is that, you know, this ship that I pass in is going to be the starship as a parameter. So the starship is going to be part of this route. It's going to be on the current params of the starship. This is different from if you're used to using route params. This doesn't get resolved until after the route is changed. So you can't use route params because that wouldn't be ready yet in the resolve. That route params doesn't get set until after resolve has been executed. So if you're going to use the route params, you have to use route.current.params. That's just a little gotcha to watch out for. And the starship is going to be here. I'm going to take that, then pass it into my resource call. So that's just get crew by starship. This is kind of out of the scope of this video, but you can check out the code to see how this is working. I'm just going to pass this in as a query to MongoLab, just some simple data I set up. Anyway, how this works is that it's using a promise. So you can see I'm using the promise library included with Angular called $q, or I've never heard anyone say it out loud, so $q works for me. And I just create a deferred object, pass return the promise, and then this view, this controller and everything won't be created and instantiated until this promise is satisfied. So I can either resolve it and pass in your result set, whatever you want it to be, or you can reject it if for some reason it fails. So what I'm doing in this example is I'm resolving it from the result. So the way that this works, so we kind of went through how we took the parameter and passed it into the resource call. Now the way we're going to take the data set and then pass it into the controller looks like this. In our resolve object, we have a crew property, and that crew is defined as this function. And this function is going to return this promise with and resolve the result of our resource call here. So you can see we have our success callback, and on success, our result gets passed into our deferred resolve. So to kind of go through that one more time, just to see how it bounces around, we go resolve crew, and then the crew is actually this result from our success. We get the result back, and then we pass it into this resolve method of our defer object, and then that'll satisfy it and say, okay, now I'm ready. You can instantiate the controller and pass the crew into the controller and assign it to the scope. So you can see crew goes from here to here, and then assigned to the scope and automatically displayed on the page. You can compare that to the before example. You would simply, you can see that I'm calling the resource, and then once the resource is ready, it's going to assign the crew to the result. So it behaves pretty much the same, but it's not using the promise, it's not using the resolve, it's just doing it in the controller. So the controller instantiates the view renders, and there's no data to display. So you'll see that empty portions of the view. But in the after, it waits for all of this to happen by using the promise and by passing that result into and instantiating the controller after this is done. So hopefully that explains what's going on. I guess one last thing to mention is that if you use reject, you can pass in whatever you need into the reject, and you can handle that in a route change error event. You can get the rejection and use it for whatever. I'm just popping up an alert. So you can either resolve or reject any of these route changes, and they will be triggered. The resolve will pass in whatever you define here into the controller, or reject will be handled in that route error change event. So that's the resolve property in routing. Hopefully that makes sense. If you have any questions, please ask them on the mailing list. If you ask them in the comments in this channel, I'll try to answer them myself, but I may not get around to them. I don't know. I'll try to be as helpful as I can. But the mailing list is a much better place to collaborate with everyone else. So hopefully that's helpful. Hopefully the demo makes sense. Again, check out the code, play around with it, and definitely use this to improve the experience of your AngularJS apps. Hope that helps.